Hello and welcome. On today's video, I'll be sharing with you how to make Nigerian assorted meat pepper soup. Please, if you're new to my YouTube channel, don't forget to support me by subscribing, like, and share this video.
Thank you.
I'll be using pepper soup spice. I'll write down the name on the description board of all the ingredients used on this video. I'll be using blended crayfish, garlic, turmeric, ginger, scotch bonnet. You can also use blended ground pepper, onions, Maggi Q, salt, scent leaf. I've got some cow foot which has been cooked already and chopped, and I've also got some intestine from the goat meat like the shaki and the rest of them. I'll also be using the goat meat itself, which is the main meat I'm using for this pepper soup. The intestine has been washed and cleaned, but I'm also going to use hot water to rinse them one more time just before cooking them. I use scotch bonnet to make this pepper soup, but you can also use grounded dry pepper. I'm just going to rinse this with hot water, then I'll put it aside. Next, I'll get the blender. I always like to blend the onions, garlic, ginger, scotch bonnet, and turmeric. I just added a bit of water before blending the onions and all. Ensure this is blend very smooth. I'll be cooking the goat meat first, and everything I've blended will go into the goat meat. I also added the blended crayfish, scent leaf, and 2 teaspoons of pepper soup spice. I use 2 different spices for this pepper soup. That's why one of them is dark brown and the other one is a bit light. I have also added the salt and Maggi, but that part of the video somehow I didn't record it. I'm sorry about that. But all the ingredients that I've listed or I've showed you is what I've used to cook this goat meat. I added a bit of water to the goat meat. The gas cooker is on a very high heat, and I leave the goat meat to cook for at least 20 minutes. The goat meat I used for this pepper soup is a bit hard, so I had to let the goat meat cook for at least 30 minutes. After cooking the goat meat for about 30 minutes, I tested the goat meat and it was a bit soft. Next, I'll be adding the shaki, that's part of the intestine. That's why it's called assorted meat pepper soup, because I use a lot of meat. I'm just going to add a bit of water. I'll add more water later on, but this is how I cook my own pepper soup. But I love recipe on how to make pepper soup. After that, I'll be adding the cow foot. Cow foot has also been cooked already. One good thing about this recipe of how I make pepper soup is that it helps me taste the flavor of the ingredient in the meat. I've also added more Maggi because the taste wasn't too good, but it's up to you. I'm just going to stir this a bit, then I'll add the last portion of the meat, which is part of the intestine. We all need pepper soup during this winter period because of the cold. At this point, I'll be adding more water. Just ensure you add enough water so your meat can be cooked and soft. I do not like when pepper soup has excess water, but just enough water so you can drink along as you eat the meat. I also added more of the 2 spices which I use, just a teaspoon of each. And then I added some more water. At this point, I'll cover the pepper soup to cook for at least 30 minutes. After cooking the meat for at least about 30 minutes, I'll be checking the meat just to ensure it's soft enough. I tasted the meat and it's soft enough. The pepper soup is ready and I'm going to serve myself some. Pepper soup is very good, especially this winter period. It's so cold here in London, so that's why I made this today. Thank you for watching this video today. I'm really grateful. Please, if you're new to my YouTube channel, don't forget to support me by subscribing to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm really grateful. And I will see you on my next video. Have a lovely day. And goodbye.